So you've got Ecamm Live and you have Zoom and you're trying to make them work together. You're trying to conduct an interview on Ecamm and have people connect with you through Zoom, but you're not sure how to pull all of that so everybody can hear each other. Well, we're going to tackle that right now. Let's go. Hey everybody, I'm Robert Kennedy, the third RK3. That's me, and welcome to my channel where we talk about the techniques and the technologies of storytelling, how you can deliver the right message in the right way on the right platform. You're probably doing a lot of your interviews and your sessions, your virtual sessions through Zoom. And in order to up the production value a bit, you want to use Ecamm so that you can bring in overlays and make it look really nice and make your audience say, oh my God, how's he doing that? Right? So here's the challenge for a lot of people. If you have Ecamm Live as your production tool, by the way, if you want to check out what Ecamm Live is, go ahead and check in the description below. I've got a link there for you to check that out. If you've got that as your production tool and you're trying to use what we call interview mode, and then have the person who is being interviewed hear what the people in Zoom are saying and vice versa, you want the people in Zoom to also hear your interviewee, it's possible to do that. Now, in order to do that, there's this one little tool that you can use to make all of this happen and come together. It's a tool called Loopback by a company named Rogue Amoeba. Now, a few weeks ago, a friend of mine named Kirk Nugent posted a video about how to bring Zoom and Ecamm Live together using Loopback, especially if you're using interview mode. I'll link his video right here so that you can check it out. And I wanted to share with you another way to do it, slightly different than Kirk's way of doing it, but I find that this way is easy, pretty easy to do. And it involves setting up a couple of virtual mics inside of Loopback. Now, in order to do this, I brought in my friend India Delgado so we can walk through this together. If you want to check out this lesson on her channel, you can also go right here or right here somewhere. Yeah. To find the video. Cool. So pretty much what we're going to do is we need to create we're trying to set this up so that you can go into Zoom using interview mode,
yeah,
but also so that the person that is in the interview in Ecamm can hear the people inside of Zoom.
Right.
So what we need to do essentially is we need to set up two virtual microphones,
okay,
that will go both ways. We'll kind of do like the circle, right?
Yeah.
So the first virtual microphone that we set up is literally already set up for you inside of Loopback.
Right.
Okay. Loopback sets up this default microphone with a pass through and you don't need to do anything else. So as a matter of fact, the only thing I want you to do is at the top where it says Loopback audio, yeah, I want you to change that name, click the pencil beside the Loopback audio in the main window and change that name to Ecamm virtual mic.
Okay.
Or you can call it Ecamm V mic, whichever one you want.
All right, boom.
Cool. Boom, so you're all set. Mm-hmm. Now you need to create a second microphone. So go down to the bottom and create a new virtual mic. Yep.
Okay.
Perfect. So this one, we're going to call this one Zoom interview mic.
All right.
Now click on the pass through and delete that. Yep. Click it and then delete it down at the bottom. Yep.
Okay.
Perfect. So now we're going to need to put two sources in here. We're going to need to put in number one, the main mic that you use, and number two, the Zoom audio.
Okay.
So go to your sources and put your mic in.
So I use the Rodecaster Pro. You can see all your audio devices here, and I'm just going to select where my mic is going through the Rodecaster. So we're going to select that. Okay.
Yep. Perfect.
And then?
All right. And then you need to select this, add a second source. And the second source is going to be Zoom into your system here. So go to the sources. Yep. And then you want to choose zoom.us. If it's not already running, then you would have just chosen select application and you would have found Zoom in your applications, wherever it is. Okay. Yep. There we go.
All right.
Perfect.
Okay.
Cool. So now one more important step. Yep. Down at the bottom of the zoom.us dialogue there, click on the options.
Yep.
And then uncheck where it says mute while capturing.
All right. Cool.
Uncheck that. Yeah. And you want to uncheck that because if there is something else that is moving at the same time or capturing audio at the same time, you won't be able to hear it because okay. it's automatically muting it. All gotcha. Right. So this okay. is all we need to set up. Okay. Right. So we're literally done with setting up our loopback stuff. So now we need to go into two places.
Okay.
We need to go into Ecamm and Zoom.
Okay.
So let's go to Zoom. Let's go to Zoom first.
So let me select okay. my camera. All right.
All right. So in Zoom, go down to where your microphones are, mm-hmm. your microphone settings. Yep. And click that. And for your microphone, you want to choose Ecamm Live, Ecamm vMic. So that's the virtual mic that we set up.
So not the speaker, the microphone.
Not the speaker.
Got it.
Yep.
Okay.
Yep.
Okay.
Ecamm vMic. So here's the reason why you're choosing that. We're trying to get all of the sound out of Ecamm into Zoom. So the okay. interview, everything that's inside of Zoom, inside of Ecamm will come into Zoom at this point. So people that are attending via Zoom will be able to hear it.
Okay.
All right.
Yep.
So that's the first step. So let's go to Ecamm Live and you can put that on live demo mode so we can see what you're doing.
All right. We are in live demo mode.
Okay, perfect. So now there are two things that you need to do inside of Ecamm. So if you go to your output tab.
Okay, over here you on the top.
Yep. You want to make sure that your audio monitor is set to Ecamm vMic.
Okay, so it's going to be choosing the same thing?
Correct.
Okay.
So your audio monitor is sending, your monitor is sending stuff out into the Ecamm vMic, because you remember we set that up as a pass-through.
Right.
Right? So it's just sending it out to the vMic, and then Zoom is now bringing that information in from the vMic.
Okay.
As your microphone. All right. So the second thing that you want to do is in your sound levels option where you choose your microphone.
Down here. Yep. Yep.
Yes. You want to choose Zoom interview mic as your microphone. Now, yours, I think you have to turn something on and off. I forgot what it is.
Yeah. So let's just go back to loopback. So I have to turn off. Can you see that on your end or no? Did it show up?
I can see it.
Okay, good.
Yep.
Okay, I just wanted to make sure you can see it. Okay. So then we just have to turn off Zoom interview mic.
Yep.
And then turn it back on.
Turn it back on.
And it should show up. So let me minimize, actually. And now we're going to go back.
To sound levels.
Oh, to sound levels. And then it showed up.
And you... Yep. That you want to choose that.
Okay.
Okay.
Yep.
So here's what's happening now. Now what you set up is that any sound that is in Zoom is going to be coming into Ecamm right along with your regular microphone that you use inside of Ecamm.
Okay.
So now we have everything set up in Loopback, Ecamm Live, and Zoom, and we need to test it. So I have my brother, Sheldon, who is a media producer as well. I'll link his information below in the description. He logged into Zoom and helped us test everything out. All right, so now we are in Zoom. Sheldon, can you hear me?
Yes, sir, I can.
He's drinking water, of course. Okay, all right, good. So people that you're on YouTube, you should be able to hear Sheldon and you should be able to hear us clearly, both myself and India. So we'll just kind of recap what we did. So we created two virtual mics. So if you want to flip back over to Zoom, to Loopback real quick. So we created two virtual mics. We created the Ecamm vMic. Click on that, which is just the pass-through microphone.
Yep, this one.
And then we created the Zoom interview mic, where we brought in the Zoom application as a source and also her microphone, right? And then inside of Zoom, we selected the Ecamm vMic as our microphone, okay? Because that is coming out of Ecamm through the audio monitor. And then we selected Zoom interview mic as our input microphone into Ecamm. All right, so we've got that circle happening there. And so as you see, we're able to hear each other clearly.
Yep.
And that's it.
Yep.
Pretty simple.
And so what we're doing is we're using Ecamm Live as the actual host. So that's how you see the overlay with myself and then Robert right below and then his brother to this way. In that direction, right? So
I'm in here. Don't worry about it. I'm in here.
He's coming in through Zoom, and then Robert came in through my interview link. So now, if you have a guest and you're trying to remote produce a show using Ecamm Live, and you want to take advantage of your overlays, your scenes, anything like that, you can produce your entire show, make it look great and professional in Ecamm Live, and then bring your guest in through Ecamm Live, and then from that you can take the way we just took this exact scene, send this into Zoom, and now the Zoom participants can contact and communicate back and forth between the guest and Zoom, and everyone can hear each other. And the most important thing is that there is no echo, because that's, I think, the biggest thing, right, RK3, that everybody keeps talking about is that people do this and then there's always an echo because they're either usually duplicating a mic somewhere, they're not turning something off somewhere else. And so with this super simple setup, and we'll just go back to the scene again. So, you know, with this super simple setup, you can see there's two applications. RK3, why don't you tell them, so what if they want to bring in, let's say, something from Chrome or another application into Zoom, what do they need to do?
I mean, you can literally add another source into that Zoom interview mic.
Right. So in here, so we have the Zoom interview mic selected. And then the same way we added
Zoom. So you can go
Zoom
to your sources.
Right. Yep. Here. Yeah. Okay.
You can, you can just add your browser there. So Google Chrome. And so whatever's playing inside of Google Chrome, whatever's playing inside of Zoom will go into to Ecamm. Your interview person will be able to hear it. And the people inside of Zoom will be able to hear it as well.
Right, exactly. And then the most important thing is that if you do add additional sources here, you want to make sure you always, always uncheck this mute, because then it won't play. So you're going to uncheck that. And now if we were to bring in, go ahead.
Well, the mute, if you leave the mute when capturing, whatever's in Google Chrome will play, but you won't be able to hear the microphone.
Right, me. You won't be able to hear me.
If you're, exactly. Yep. So it would have muted your microphone.
Right.
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you so much for helping me. I appreciate you. It's all set up. I'm now with my Mac Mini. I'm back to normal, back in business. So I appreciate you. If there's anything I can do for you, let me know. And thank
you. Absolutely. Hopefully this was helpful for everybody. I know that sometimes you're trying to figure out little things like this and you can pull your hair out. That's why I ain't got none. So trying to figure this out. So hopefully this was helpful to somebody and it was a hair saving mechanism.
Absolutely. Let us know. Leave us some comments.
I hope that was helpful for you. If you are an Ecamm Live person, again, you can check the description to find the link to download that. If you are a Zoom person, well, I can share some information with you about that also. I've got a great deal on how to get Zoom for even cheaper. And you can find that information in the description as well. If you found this helpful, give me a thumbs up, like the video, share the video, and then finally subscribe to the channel. Don't forget to hit that bell so that you can be notified whenever I drop new videos on this channel. And I'll be doing that every Tuesday and Thursday. So if you're ready to learn more about the techniques and the technologies of storytelling, come on back to the channel and I'll see you in the next video.